The Child Jesus and I, Testimony of My Experiences. The sacred humanity of Jesus is that part of the divinity that corresponds to the eternal Word, the Word of God incarnate. From the moment the Blessed Virgin Mary was conceived by the Holy Spirit, God became man, and His sacred humanity is the second person of the Blessed Trinity, the Word of God, God the Son, Emmanuel, God with us. Jesus is our way, truth, and life, our God, Lord, King, and Savior. That is why any part of His sacred humanity deserves our adoration. During my childhood in Colombia, my native country, I had the privilege of leading every year the Christmas Novena to the Child Jesus. It is a devotion that I have lived throughout my life and that has given me beautiful moments. I have transmitted it to my children. And this devotion to the Child Jesus is a continuous company embracing this God who has become small, tender, weak, loving, and very desirous of our affections. Not because of this devotion should we neglect devotion to Jesus in other very important ways. We must adore Jesus in the Blessed Sacrament of the altar, for He is God with us in the Holy Eucharist. For over 30 years, I have had devotion to Holy Mass daily, as well as the recitation of the Holy Rosary and the Chaplet of Divine Mercy. We must also adore God in His Holy Word, since that Word is the same God who speaks to us in the Holy Scriptures. Well, now I want to share with you about some very beautiful experiences I have had with the Child Jesus. About 30 years ago, I just had my reconversion to the faith. I used to help the priest of my parish to print the Sunday bulletins. And for this, I would go into the school library where the photocopying machine was. While the bulletins were ready, I would pray in front of an image of the Blessed Virgin Mary with the Child Jesus in her arms. It was a statue of granulated clay. One day, while I was praying and waiting for the bulletins, I had this vision. The Child Jesus got down from the arms of the Blessed Virgin Mary and began to hide behind her and then come out as children do. He would look at me, hide, and I would anxiously wait for him and he would reappear. This was an invitation to have great devotion to him, but I did not understand this at the time. This God-made child feels the need for our affection, and we must reciprocate. Then, on a certain occasion, I had a vision of His face, and also of the face of the Blessed Virgin Mary. They were 2 or 3 years old. The texture of their faces, the perfection of the skin, the details and colors in such high resolution, made me see images as if they were from another world. It was something very beautiful. On another occasion, I saw the Child Jesus with a tiny watering can. He was going through a garden, sprinkling water from the flowers. I always make my spiritual communion several times a day. And at night, when I wake up, one night, when it was about 12:30, I asked the Lord to give me His body, blood, soul, and divinity in spiritual communion. The Lord answered me with this beautiful vision. I was on Calvary with my wife. Everything was very dark. The Lord was crucified. The Virgin Mary approached me. I opened my hands to receive Holy Communion. She placed the little baby Jesus about 6 centimeters long, which I adored with great joy. Then she gave this same communion to my wife and to Saint John, the apostle, was also there. My wife was troubled for a moment and said, "But how is this? This cannot be free." Then I turned out with my face about 30 centimeters from the face of the crucified Lord, who in the midst of his anguish had a smile for me and said to me in a low voice, "Yes, it is free." What a beautiful spiritual communion. About a year ago, I had this vision of the child Jesus. He was about 4 years old. He was sitting on a high wooden bench. In front of him, there were some shelves in the shape of little steps forming a triangle. On each step, there were about 10 or 12 gallon cans filled with paint of different colors. There were about 7 steps, so there were about 84 gallons of paint, all with beautiful colors, all open. The child Jesus had a long brush in his hand and was ready to start painting. In the spirit, he told me that he was ready to paint my day. He wanted me to tell him what I wanted him to paint. The beauty of this vision is that Jesus is interested daily in helping us to live our day. When I look at the sky, the child Jesus presents me with figures of little animals and childish things. Sometimes he shows me dragons, battles, and fire. Sometimes human or divine figures. Daily I enjoy looking at the sky to discover beautiful things. I always sleep hugging a small pillow to feel more comfortable. One day I was inspired to have the image of baby Jesus engraved on it. And that is how for some time now I have been sleeping with the child Jesus every night. He is my great companion. I fall asleep hugging him and talking to him, asking the Virgin Mary to lull us to sleep. When I started doing this, I heard the voice that said, "This little baby Jesus will shine." My wife had several pictures of the baby Jesus printed. She made little pillows to give to all our grandchildren who live overseas. We have to put in their hearts this great devotion to the child Jesus. Well, here is what the Word of God says. The kingdom of heaven belongs to children and to those who can be like little children. Matthew 19, verse 14. So, in the child Jesus, we find again that tenderness that brings us closer to God the Father, who rejoices in the innocence of our souls when we live spiritually as children. I ask the child Jesus to embrace me. One night, while I was sleeping on my side, I woke up feeling that a child was hugging my back. I reacted, thinking that it could be a bad spirit, and I ordered him in the name of Jesus to leave. But he did not leave. I realized that my prayer was being answered. I felt much peace in the affection of that child Jesus who embraced me. How good it would be if we all became aware of this very important devotion to the child Jesus. No matter what the advocation is, Jesus is God. More than 30 years ago, the Holy Spirit inspired me this prayer, which I pray with my family. O sweetest infant Jesus, Word of God incarnate, by the merits of your divine purity and your infancy, purify my body and soul. Amen. If you like this video, please give us a like, subscribe to our channel, The Work of God, share on social networks, and don't forget to leave your valuable comments. How do you like the devotion to the child Jesus? God bless you.